Welcome viewers and dear learners to my channel Learning English with Amol. This is the second video about summary writing. In the first video, we focused on the basic concept of summary writing, why summary writing is important and what is the purpose behind summarization of the given content. Thereafter, we learned about the do's and don'ts which are essential while preparing any summary. In this video, we will focus on how we can summarize the given content by following some of the tactics and the ways, the methodologies which we need to apply in detail. Dear students, let us revise few things before we move on. The foremost thing is that identify the main idea through the process of asking questions while reading the given passage. Once you understand or find out the main idea, you can start writing accordingly. Second thing is form short sentences on your own, and all it required a great skill to formulate a long sentence there into a short one without losing its original spirit. Third thing is to connect the sentences using linkers. There are various linkers which you have to apply while converting the long sentences or two or more sentences into one sentence. Next point is remove redundant words and sentences from the key sentence. And all it required to minimize the words and to curtail the things. And for that, you need to follow some of the basic things which we are going to learn in this video. Omit the details. When you are writing, your focus must be there on the key points, not on the details. And avoid your own interpretation. That is more important. As earlier discussed, that you need not put your own ideas and your own reflection on the given content. Just put it very objectively what is given therein. Next point is don'ts of summary writing, which we already have discussed. You just see this figure. I won't discuss about it right now. Let us move over to the next point, that is how we can curtail the sentences for making them short. The first skill which we have to acquire to shorten the sentences is to cut redundant words. What is meant by redundant words? The words which are unnecessarily used in a sentence, and to minimize the number of words in a sentence, that is cutting the redundant words. Here are some examples. Circle around can become only circle. Write down can become write. Added bonus is simply a bonus. Get to the point as quickly as possible is really, you can write get to the point. Close proximity is itself is close. And last one, during the course of is you can write as during. So these are the few tips. These are not the first and the last one. These are few examples which here are cited. You can add another examples to get it known how to cut the redundant words. In short, we have to minimize the number of words in our sentence. So this is the first step, how you can shorten your sentence by minimizing the words in this fashion. Next is avoid adverbs. Adverbs unnecessarily lengthen the sentence, so it can be also removed. For example, that is usually a good thing to do, As you can see, the words in italics means the font which is quite different, and all the words having ly, they all are adverbs. So if you remove them, that's a good thing to do. That can also serve the same as the, that's usually a good thing to do. Next is, that is fairly good coffee. So that can be written like that's good coffee. I totally agree can be changed into I agree. Actually, I disagree can be converted into I disagree. So just delete all those italicized words and rewrite. So by removing a single word also, you can shorten the sentence. Then very important thing is that how you can have a one word substitution for a number of words together or a phrase. The life story of a man written by himself. This entire expression has only a word, that is autobiography. A sound that cannot be heard, that is inaudible. A list of books is called as catalog. A sentence whose meaning is unclear, that is ambiguous. So all such expressions can have a word to serve the message. That's why one word substitution is one of the best methods of curtailing or shortening the sentence. So please apply it wherever it is possible. Next is use of noun in apposition. This is bit care need to be taken while understanding this point. Apposition is a grammatical construction in which two elements, normally noun phrases, are placed side by side with one element serving to identify the other in different way. The two elements are said to be in apposition. Apposition can be used to make the compound sentence short and simple. For example, Neha is their eldest child and she is very intelligent. Now, how it can be converted by applying apposition, let us see. Now, here is the example of application of apposition. Neha, their eldest child, is very intelligent. Earlier, Neha is the eldest child and she is very intelligent. That was written, but here we have curtailed it and modified it in a way that here the subject Neha and the eldest child both are one and is very intelligent. That is the only thing that we had to serve. So here Neha and their eldest child are the same person. So this is how you can modify a compound sentence in such a way. Next is transforming complex to simple, then converting some of the given compound and complex sentences into simple. These are also the few ways whereby you can also shorten the length of your original sentence. For example, Nagpur is the city where oranges grow. Now, this complex sentence which is having where as a conjunction, you can remove it in a way. Oranges grow in Nagpur. So that is also serving the same. The old man is so weak that he cannot walk. It can be converted into simple by applying the old man is too weak to walk. So these are the few examples, not necessarily only two can be applied. There are so many ways whereby you can shorten your sentences. In short, these are the few tips which if you apply while writing the summary of your passage, definitely you can write your passage exactly in the word limits given to you. Next is, change the following sentences into simple. Mr. Rohit is the member and he is also the director. You can write it like, Mr. Rohit is the member, Mr. Rohit is a director and member. So Mr. Rohit, the member, is also the director, is the way you can convert the given sentence into simple one. The room is so small that it cannot accommodate many people. The room is small to accommodate many people. Dear students, here is a sample of summary. Learning disability handled with care. This is the title which is given to this summary. Learning disability is an umbrella term for many learning problems like reading, writing, listening, speaking, reasoning, maths and other physical and motor difficulties. If you go into the original passage, you will find that for this much content, there were more than 5 to 7 sentences. But here, this sentence has been written in a way that the key point that learning disability is an umbrella term, which is given therein, and here some of the issues like reading, writing, listening, speaking, reasoning, maths and other physical and motor difficulties, they all are covered there in a single sentence by using the linkers like. So this is how you can write. Next is, these problems need to be identified and investigated. In original passage, there are 2 or more sentences for this, but as here it is modified there into a single sentence that you need to identify the problems and also investigate. A child can be diagnosed with more than one learning disability like dyslexia, dysgraphia, auditory processing disorder, etc. All these things are included there into a single sentence. Such disorders can be dealt with using various methods in a regular classroom. One of the ways is inclusion. You can see here that the sentences are very short in length, as well as the sentences are mostly in simple type. Implementation of inclusion may vary, but it has a positive effect on the learning disabled. Though the idea of inclusion is not popular in our country, it can prove useful to handle such children. In short, you can write all such sentences by applying some of the connectors like though. One more is here, along with the methods and techniques, the children also need encouragement and moral support to progress with self-confidence and determination. Dear students, here is just a simple sample given of how you can convert the detailed passage there into a summarized passage. So please follow all these tips and skills which you need to apply while preparing any long passage there into a short summary. If you like this video, please mark like, share it with your friends and relatives, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you.